that is kind of near and dear to my heart is the fact that I have a grandchild that has a cognitive disability. So if you think of yourself when you're playing this role as having your own, the body that you have, but having the brain of a four-year-old, you know, the mentality of a four-year-old, and people expect so much more of you because you look like you should know, and it's very hard for you. So when you have a person with a cognitive disability, one thing you want to do is make sure that you speak very clearly and directly to the person. They need very concrete words. They need you to repeat it several times until they finally get it. So you have to have a lot of patience. You may want to say, my name is, and for example, my name is Betty, and I'm here to help you. And you want to say, my job is a nurse, or I'm a soldier, and I'm here to help you. You want to keep repeating those kind of things. Then you can give them an explanation as far as what you're going to do. And for example, if you're going to be deconning, you want to say, I'm going to be putting you through this shower, and it's going to help get rid of the particles or the dirt that you have on you. You have to use very concrete words with them. And then if you have pictures, that's very good. You want to make sure that you give them enough time so that they are able to understand. Offer them gentle assistance. For example, you know, reach out your arm and tell them they can either hold on to your arm or your elbow and you'll guide them. But never go up to somebody grab them and try to lead them without giving them an explanation. If you're a person with a cognitive disability, mobility devices, and that might not only be a wheelchair, that could be a headboard, it could be several things to help them, braces, any kind of health considerations, any kind of allergies, look and see if they have an ID band, and any kind of special communication devices that they might need, especially people that have cerebral palsy may have a language board or something like that. When you see the person starting to get stressed or confused, try to explain again, repeat things, try to reassure them. That is so critical that you get them on board and they understand what you're doing. And always try to say, I know you're afraid, that's okay, but I'm here and we're safe. So those are the things that you want to keep repeating to the person. I've got you, we're safe. And reunite you with your family at lunchtime, dinner, whatever. Thank you all.